old. We're going to talk today about fetal bradycardia, or a baby's low heart rate, and a traumatic brain injury during birth. And so I use the term fetal bradycardia, and according to ACOG, fetal bradycardia is when the baby's baseline on the electronic fetal heart monitor, when the heart rate is about 110 beats per minute and lower. Now, if you have a baby that is in bradycardia or a low heart rate for a considerable amount of time, then that baby can run the risk of suffering a traumatic brain injury. And in our context, that brain injury would be HIE or hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. From time to time, we will have mothers, when they contact us, they will tell us, or other individuals who were in the labor and delivery room, they'll let us know that, look, the nurses or the doctors told mom or was informing the family that there were issues with the baby's heart rate. And when this occurs, there are certain things that doctors and nurses that they can do to try to help rectify it, namely moving mom or moving her position or giving her a bolus or giving oxygen. There's things that they can try to do to help rectify and get that heart rate back up. But if these things are not working, if the baby is going on, that heart rate is continuing to stay low, then in some instances, the doctors may have to move to that emergency C-section. So for the purpose of this video today, like I said, I want to explain and help you understand that condition, fetal bradycardia, and why it can be very serious, especially if it is left to go on and not rectified, and how in some instances it can create a reduction in blood and oxygen, which can lead to the traumatic brain injury, HIE, or hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. If you have more questions, maybe you're watching this video today because you were told your baby had a low heart rate, or maybe the bradycardia was present during labor and delivery, and now your baby has suffered an HIE diagnosis, or maybe even a subsequent CP or a cerebral palsy diagnosis, and you have questions, there's a telephone number on the screen. I advise you to go ahead and pick up the phone and call me. I answer questions like yours all the time about these types of issues. This is what we do. One more thing I want to make sure that you understand, that I practice law in the state of Maryland, and if you are not in Maryland and you would like to reach out and contact me, just understand that we have to use local counsel, or in other words, an attorney in your state, and that's something that we can help work with you, try to help work with you on, but I just want to make sure that you understand that local counsel aspect of things, and understand that there is no cost to talk with me about your baby's story. All right, that's going to be it for today's quick educational video. Again, I'm Marcus Boston, and I'm one of the childbirth injury and medical malpractice attorneys practicing law in the state of Maryland at Boston Law Group, LLC. And we'll talk with you next time. Take care. Enjoy the rest of your day.